I have a Minolta MD 50mm f1.7 lens here, and I'm going to be fully disassembling. This lens is almost identical in its cosmetic appearance and how it's constructed internally to the f2 version of the same lens, the MD version, without the rocker X or any of those other brandings on there. So it's easy to take apart, but like the f2 version, it's not as repairable as some of the earlier MC lenses. A lot of the components are really well integrated together, such as having the diaphragm and the focusing mechanism as a single piece, and the optics are all encased in plastic as well, so you can't really repair those. But you can make minor repairs, and for actually making minor repairs, it's actually a lot easier to take apart than the earlier MC lenses. I'm going to be fully disassembling this lens, removing all the body sections, the optics, getting access to the diaphragm, and allowing the lens to be pretty much fully repaired. I'll start on the front here, and like on the F2 version of this lens, there's on the name ring going around here, the plastic name ring, there's no spots for a spanning wrench. So on this copy, the ring here happened to be loose, so if I grabbed on the two sides here, I could just loosen it up. But if your copy is a little bit more tight and you can't get it off, you can use a piece of pipe with something like tape on the end to actually go in and get some traction there and actually unscrew this. So I'll just unscrew this plastic name ring. Next up, we have the ring here, this black ring that holds the filters, and the name ring was also screwing into. It has six screws total going around. There are three that are kind of elevated above the rest, going around here, here, and here. And I'm going to undo these to just lift off this ring. And now we have access to the front optical piece in here, this large black plastic piece going around here, and it's just held in place by these three screws going around here, so the other three out of the six. Now I can just lift off this entire front optical piece. Much like on the F2 version of this lens, it is all encased in plastic, so it's not really repairable if there's fungus or anything inside, not just on the front or back surfaces. It's not something you can really take apart, to my knowledge, because it all is just one single black plastic piece here. And now we also have access to the front of the diaphragm. So if there's a little bit of oil on here, you can try cleaning it off at this stage, but I'm actually going to get access to the back of the diaphragm now, so I'll flip over the lens. And on the back section here, I have the mounting plate going around here, which just has these four screws that are holding it in place. And this is going to just lift off the entire back assembly, including the silver mount here and this black ring going around here. So now I can just lift off this plate. And there's this little brass colored washer type thing in here that may be loose as well. In this copy, it's kind of stuck in this part, but on other copies it may fall out of this. And you have the mounting plate over here, which has the stop down lever integrated, and then the mechanical coupling of the stop down lever and the aperture control ring to the diaphragm control. And I'll talk a little bit more about the coupling on the reassembly. It's almost identical to the F2 version of the lens though. And then we have the back of the lens here with the optical piece in the center, and then the aperture control ring going around here, and then this inner ring down here is the inner part of the focusing mechanism, and it's also where the diaphragm is housed. That's just one single piece. So now I'm going to remove the aperture control ring, which is just going around up here, and as I move it back and forth, it has a little clicking sound that it makes, and that is from a little ball bearing. Let me find where it is on this lens, over in here. So I just need to be careful when lifting this off to not lose the little ball bearing. All right, so there's the little ball bearing and the aperture control ring, which I'll just set aside. And now I'll remove the back optical piece to get access to the back of the diaphragm as well. So on the back optical piece here, there's the actual optical piece, and then there's this black kind of washer that's going around here, and they're both held in place by the same three screws going around there. So I'll remove these three screws and lift off these two pieces. All right, so I'll lift off the back optical piece here. Again, like the front optical piece, it's entirely encased in plastic, so you can clean the exterior surfaces very easily, but if there's actually a fungus inside of here, it's not something that can really be cleaned out. And now I have access to the back of the diaphragm blades as well. And because of how the diaphragm is situated and how it's integrated into the focusing mechanism, it's actually built into the inner part of the focusing mechanism, this kind of this ring in here. This is really the best spot, I think, to clean off the diaphragm. You can clean the front and you can clean the back. I'll actually remove the piece that this is in, the diaphragm intersection here, from the rest of the lens. That doesn't get you a whole lot. The way, and I'll explain later how you can actually take out the diaphragm as well from the lens and disassemble it and clean the individual blades, but that's a lot more involved than I'm going to get into for this particular lens. To actually remove the diaphragm itself and the inner part of the focusing mechanism, I'm going to, let me first remove the focusing ring going around here on the outside of the lens, and that is just held in place by the three screws going around here, here, and here on the silver kind of washer thing down here. So I'll undo these three screws. And once this piece is removed, you have to zero the lens back to infinity properly, but it's not too bad on this lens. It's pretty easy. Just during the reassembly, you leave off one or two components and then mount the lens on your camera and zero it back to infinity. So it's not very hard on this particular lens. Okay, and now I can see the inner part of the focusing mechanism that I need to grab later on a little bit better. So it's right this part up here, and that's actually what's containing the diaphragm as well. So while the lens is in this current position, I'm just going to flip this over again. And looking at the back section here, there's two bars in the inner part of the focusing mechanism, here and here. And they're going into the outer part of the focusing mechanism, into little tracks up here and up here. And those are actually what are locking the inner part of the focusing mechanism in place, so that as I focus in and out, it goes up and down instead of just spinning around. So I'm going to undo these two bars. This one, you need to undo the screws fully, but on this one over here, you only have to undo them partially, and then the bar itself will just slide out. There's that one. And the other one, I have to undo the screws fully to remove this other piece. All right, and now I'll grab the front section of the lens up here, and I'm going to grab with one hand, I'm going to grab the bottom section down here and this inner ring right here, and with the other hand, I'm going to grab this top section up here, which is the diaphragm and inner part of the focusing mechanism, and just slowly spin this out of the lens. And once it gets kind of near the end here, I want to just be a little careful. And once it actually falls out, I'm going to note where on the lens it fell out of the lens. So I'm going to just use some pencil to kind of mark that this is the spot over by the numbers down there in the center of the focusing point down there. So I know how to attach this properly, as long as I don't really move the black ring on the inner part of this black ring around too much. So now I have the diaphragm and inner part of the focusing mechanism on its own, as well as the body section here on its own, as much as I could really figure out how to take it apart. I believe you can take this further apart, but I didn't find an easy way to do that. And to actually, if the diaphragm does have more than just a little bit of oil on it, the way that it can be cleaned off is just removing the actual blades from the diaphragm mechanism, and then you have to reassemble the diaphragm mechanism and the blades. So the way that that's accomplished, it's pretty straightforward on this lens. All you have to do is undo these three screws right here. They kind of have a little bit of adhesive, but it shouldn't be too hard to just power through that. And then you can lift off this silver ring here, and then there's a black ring underneath that, which is actually holding on the diaphragm blades. And once that black ring is removed, the blades should just fall out of place. On the back section here as well, there's a little spring going right here. This is kind of holding it open in its standard state. And you can unhook the little spring over here, and then there's a back plate that holds on the back of the diaphragm blades, which is connected to this post. So you can remove all those components along with all the six little blades and things. Clean those off really well using just isopropyl alcohol or some similar cleaning solution, and then reassemble it outside of the lens in the same order, and then slide that back plate back in so that the post is going through the hole, the second hole on this side, and the other little post is hooked back up to the spring over here. And once that's complete, you can tighten everything back down with the silver ring in here. So that's got the disassembly of the lens complete. And as you can see, there aren't that many components, very similar to the MD 50mm f2 lens, just a few really well integrated components. So you can't really make the same types of repairs that you can on some of the MC lenses, which have many more components. Those are much more repairable, but this one's a whole lot easier to take apart. You have things like the focusing ring here. Now let me get the screws out of there. You have focusing ring and the other body sections like the filter ring holder and the main body section here with the depth of field scale. Separate from the optics, so the front and back optics, which you can clean the front and back surfaces of those, but not inside the optics. And things like the diaphragm, an inner part of the focusing mechanism, and the back mounting plate ring, which has all the mechanical couplings separate as well, so that those can all be repaired. Now I'll start on the reassembly of this lens. It's also pretty straightforward to put back together, almost identical to the 50mm f2 MD lens, so not too complex overall. I'll start by getting the diaphragm mechanism here back into the main lens body. So this piece over here with the depth of field scale and all that on there. So I'm gonna find where I kind of had marked on here, right over here, that this is the orientation that was lining up with the depth of field scale right there. And these two just screw back together, but it's important to get them back together in the right orientation, or else you have to fiddle around and try to get them locking together properly. It's just an extra step if you don't make the markings originally. So I'll screw these back together. Okay, and on the back section here, I want to have it lined up so that the two screws that I left in place are over near the side here with the track a little bit in front of it, and these other two screws over here are a little bit in front of this track over here. So somewhat like that. So to actually lock this in place, first off I'll get the little metal component over here back in place by sliding it over the screws and into the track on this side. And just lock this down. Now this other one on this side should line up properly as well. So I'll get this little metal component into the track up here and then reattach it using the two screws here and here. All right, and now should be able to focus that in and out. Next up, I'm going to reattach the back optical piece here. So it has the two different sides going around here. On the back section, there's the, looking at this back optical piece, you want the side with the hollow section over here to be facing up, and so that it goes over the three screw holes over like that. And I'll reattach this little metal ring kind of washer on top of here as well. It goes with the gap in the metal ring over here next to the stop down lever right here, or I guess it's the aperture or diaphragm control mechanism. And then I'll reattach this using the three long screws that go through both of these pieces. Alright, and now I'll get the aperture control ring back in place with the little ball bearing as well. So it's just going to slide in place. You can see there's a kind of a gap in this ring up here. It's going to slide so that the curve, the aperture control curve down here, is going into that ring with this little black post going upwards, like that. And then the ball bearing itself is going to be pressed up into the aperture control ring against these little grooves over here. So to get this lined up properly, on the aperture control ring, I'm going to find there's a little pocket right here where the ball bearing is going to sit. So I'm going to get the ball bearing in place. And now on the main lens body, I'm going to press the ball bearing up against the side of the lens so that it goes into that pocket, and then slide over the aperture control ring so that it's going into the gap in here. And it should go flat against there, and when I rotate this back and forth, it should make the nice clicking sound. And to complete the back reassembly here, I'll reattach the mounting plate. So that has the, this is actually what is controlling the, it's coupling in the stop-down lever and the aperture control ring into the diaphragm. So the diaphragm itself is controlled by this little post on the main lens body over here. And then, much like the 50mm f2 MD, this setup is very similar on the back mounting plate here. The stop-down lever itself and the aperture control ring are both controlling this metal crescent-shaped piece over here. And this metal crescent-shaped piece is being hooked up into this diaphragm control lever by this little pocket right here on the back mounting plate. So that lever goes into the little pocket here. So the stop-down lever itself directly controls this crescent-shaped piece. So when I move it back and forth, it's directly controlling that. And then the aperture control ring has the, see where it is, the aperture control curve over here. And that curve is also controlling the aperture control ring through the same bar by this little post over here. So this little post is going to sit in front of the aperture control curve. And as it moves up and down that curve, it's going to also open and close the diaphragm. So to get this lined up properly, I'm going to get the diaphragm control lever over here back through the little pocket on this side and just work this back and forth until it's lined up on the back of the lens as well and completely flat. So here I should see the four screw holes are all lined up going around here, and when I hit the stop down lever or turn the aperture control ring just holding this in place, both should control the aperture in there. So I'll reattach this using the four screws on the mounting plate. All right, and now I have the back reassembly of the lens complete, so I can put on a back lens cap here to just give me a better surface to work on for the front reassembly. Starting on the front reassembly, first I want to get the focusing ring here back in place, just in a general position. It has to be zeroed back to infinity properly at a later stage, but I need to just get it in its general position right now. So looking at the focusing ring, it has this little kind of notch right here that's sticking out from the back section. And it needs to line up so that the numbers for the aperture control ring go between infinity over here and the minimum focusing distance of 0.45 meters, and it kind of should stop at those two extremes when I'm just spinning this back and forth. This actually won't be focusing it, but it needs to be in that position. To actually get this locked back in place, I'm going to use this silver washer that sits on the inside of this here, and then the three screws going down into this intersection here, here, and here to actually line that up. So it's a little easier to get this started and get the three screws in place outside of the lens and then line it up properly and just tighten that down. And now I'm just going to reattach it in any old position as long as the numbers are lining up properly. And I don't need to tighten it down fully at this stage, I just want to have it in some position so that I can work with it later. Okay. Now I'll reattach the front optical piece, which is just going to go also screwed into this top section here. So it just sits on top of here, and then I'll line up the, should be three screws that can line up in this top section here. And And this is actually now the stage where you can take the lens and focus it back to infinity properly. So I'm just going to loosen up the focusing ring slightly by loosening up the three screws on the silver washer. And what you do to focus the lens back to infinity or zero it back to infinity properly is with the lens in its current state, you just mount it on your camera and you would tighten down the aperture or the focusing ring here so that when it spins around it is focusing. And you would find where it's properly focused optically at infinity. So you just spin this around, and if it gets stuck, like right now it's getting stuck over by the 1.2, you would just loosen this up again and spin this around so into a different position if it's not optically focused properly, and loosen it down or tighten it down again. You just keep repeating that process until it's optically focused in infinity. And once you found where it's optically focused in infinity, you would loosen up the screws in here and spin around the focusing ring independently of the focusing mechanism on the inside, and just tighten that back down so that it, when it's set to be optically focused at infinity, the reading over here is also showing infinity. So I'm just going to assume that this is infinity because I'm not going to go through that whole process. And once it's focused to infinity, you should be able to go through the entire range from infinity over here to the minimum focusing distance. Now for the final parts of the reassembly of the front of the lens, I have the filter ring holder right here, which is going to sit with the three screws, these three sections here, going into open sections around here, and then one of these screws that we attached previously going into that hole right there. And I'll tighten this down with the three screws going around here. And finally, to complete the reassembly, I'll reattach the name ring, which just screws in place into the filter ring holder. Alright, so that has the reassembly of this lens complete. Overall, it's almost exactly the same, both externally and its appearance and how it's constructed internally to the 50mm f2 version of this lens, the regular MD version. So it's a very easy lens to take apart, like that F2 version, and it's a very easy lens to put back together. A lot of really large components that are easy to take apart, and you don't need fancy tools like a spanning wrench, you just need a screwdriver to take it all apart and repair it. But unfortunately, like the F2 version of the lens, because it does use these big integrated components, it also can't be repaired the same way. You can't actually clean inside the optics like you can on a lot of the earlier MC lenses, and you can't make the same types of repairs as well because the components are so specialized, and they're made of cheaper materials as well. So while you can take this lens apart very easily, it's not one that can be as well repaired.